Not far from the Twin Cities, in central Minnesota, you'll find the Cuyuna Lakes Recreation Area. When you see it now on a sunny fall day, it's almost impossible to believe that this is what it looked like just a few decades ago.
The towns of Crosby, Ironton, Deerwood, and Cuyuna that make up the area sit at the southernmost tip of the Iron Range. And when mining died out, the towns struggled to survive. But as Julie and I found out, the people who live there took what the mines left behind and turned it into solid gold.
This might be the best way to see the Cuyuna Country State Recreation Area, but the best way to experience it is with a buddy on a bike.
Ready?
Yep.
Go, girl.
This Minnesota State Park, just 2 hours north of the Twin Cities, offers 70 miles of award-winning one-way mountain bike trails for everyone from newbies like Belle and me to more thrill-seeking, experienced riders.
We see more and more people who are saying, I want to spend time outdoors. I want to try this mountain bike thing.
Eric Moe, head of the Cuyuna Lakes mountain bike crew, says the popularity of the sport and this park is exploding.
It's just such a beautiful, rich area to try it in, especially with the rich history. We never forget that our current state is based on the history of mining in the area.
It's hard to believe, but 50 years ago, this is what the area looked like. Situated at the southernmost tip of the Iron Range, in the 50s and 60s, more than 30 mines operated here. But by the late 70s, most of them had shut down, forcing many businesses in the towns surrounding them to do the same.
This is my hometown.
Aubrey Koop, the head of the Cuyuna Lakes Chamber of Commerce, grew up in Crosby, the heart of the Cuyuna Lakes area.
Through the 90s and into the mid-2000s, there was not a lot of hope here.
And what would you say the percentage of stores on Main Street that were boarded up were?
I'd say 30% to 40% were unoccupied. We're falling into disrepair.
And the land around it, well?
That's probably my least favorite part of the story. It became a dumping zone. There was furniture, there were burnt out cars.
But as the years passed, the land started to heal, and the people who live here decided to save it.
I can't even tell you about the pounds and pounds of garbage that volunteers went into and pulled out of these mine pits.
It's really been organic, grassroots, all those things that you didn't know that's the way to build a town, but that's how it's happened.
Business owner Jonna Johnson ran the chamber at the time and says that volunteer spirit sparked a movement that really caught fire when a mountain biking scout came to town and told them the topography created by the mines would make for world-class trails. Once again, volunteers paved the way, building the first 5 miles of trails that connect the towns of Crosby, Ironton, Cuyuna, and Deerwood.
Lots and lots of work, fundraising for the trail, getting land acquisition.
Every year, with the help of the DNR and state and federal funding, they built more trails, and more people started discovering Cuyuna.
I think when the trails opened, there was like 24,000 people that we saw, and that was huge. And now I'm thinking it's 360,000 people, so that's a 10-year change.
Visitors are finding a lot of beauty outside of the trails as well, including a network of pristine spring-fed lakes.
And not just any lake, there are 28 of these spring-fed lakes that used to be mines. They're clear as a bell, so perfect for kayaking, paddling, or scuba diving, and some of them are as deep as 500 feet.
It's going up like this. It's definitely, there's no plateau in sight.
All those visitors attracted the attention of entrepreneurs like Jake Zesch, who used to come to Crosby from Milwaukee to visit his in-laws.
I saw downtown and I saw all these other little businesses starting and kind of watching them just boom in the first year that they opened up and then stay busy.
2 years ago, he and his wife decided to open a business of their own. They bought some of the last land available in Crosby and built four cabins that make up the Cuyuna Cabin Collection, which opened June 1st.
It has been phenomenal. If there was 2 or 3 days open for the entire month, that was a shock.
Isn't that crazy?
I'm amazed. It seems like every week there's something else opening in this area.
The main streets of these towns now filled with coffee shops, restaurants, bike shops, and breweries. A testament not just to the popularity of this sport and these trails, but also to the people who live here.
There's the Cuyuna grit. There were a lot of us that wanted to show off what we had and had the vision and the drive.
I love it.
You have to see it to believe it. Come here, give it a shot. There's something for everyone here to do.
One more cool thing to come out of this remarkable turnaround in Cuyuna Lakes. They are now helping other mining towns like Chisholm do the same. Chisholm, by the way, opened 25 miles of mountain bike trail in 2020.
Great story.
It was so fun. We really, truly love the people there. And it doesn't shut down just because winter is coming. A lot of people fat bike tire, is that what you call it?
Yeah, fat tire
I don't
bike.
Obviously. Fat tire bike up there.
Yep.
Snowmobile, snowshoe, yep. Ice fish. There's tons of stuff to do.
And I assume that there's places you can rent bikes. That's the first thing I thought of when I saw people biking. Can
a bunch of bike stores have opened up. We met actually a lot of women running these stores too, I have to say. And the kayaks too, those clear kayaks were so super cool on a sunny day. Because again, those lakes are really pristine. They don't have houses around them. And because they're spring fed and they were the actual mines, they're 300, 400, 500 feet deep.
Beautiful.
And they're stocked. There's trout. So a lot of people fish up there. So anyway, it's a beautiful part of the state that we both found.
Fun
it was really
out.
Great. Yeah, a lot of people.